गुड मॉर्निंग वंदे मातरम. सो वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू. दिस मॉर्निंग वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट इज ऑन ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन. सो ऑलमोस्ट दिस टॉपिक दैट इज द गोल ऑफ अवर साधना ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एंड परफेक्शन. ऑन दिस टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू लिटिल डिस्कस इन ब्रीफ ऑफ कोर्स फ्रॉम द राइटिंग्स ऑफ मदर एंड श्री अरविंदो ऑन ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन. Transformation, the term we have Sri Aurobindo quotes that transformation and supermind are the two terms I have brought. This is the Sri Aurobindo's dream creation, of course. So anyway, the transformation, naturally we know it is a big thing for us, and it is of course the process, and actually we are trying for this transformation. Of course, it is a very difficult process. It can't be done by our own effort. Without an unaided effort, this transformation is never possible. That we know. It has been advised. Of course, it has been cautioned by Sri Aurobindo. This transformation only can be done by a power infinitely greater than the man's own force. So, infinitely greater than a man's force means just imagine how great it is. Infinity, not a countable number. It can't be predicted. But thing is that it is only possible with the grace of the Divine Mother, and it is the new creation and transformation as the work of the Mother. That's what for that only Mother and Sri Aurobindo they have come. It is the in Mother's province this new creation and transformation, both the things are done, and it is done only by the Supreme Mother. It is only done by the Divine Mother. Transformation, the terms when we come across, when we listen, when we try to analyze or try to understand, the thing is that something will be transformed, and it is there should be a permanent stage, transformed to a permanency. So transformation means a shape will go that will be subtracted, and another form, another shape will come. So when we understand and we try to give example, just one simple example we give is that caterpillar is converted, transformed to butterfly. Condition satisfies, its old form is gone, new form has come, that is butterfly. Caterpillar was ugly looking, and it is beautiful. Butterfly is very worthy of looking, very interesting. So anyway, second example we also get that these trees and these leaves, these branches, actually dug under the ground, but earth. Then after many years, of course, it turned, it got transformed temporarily into coal, that is a black diamond. Then after still a long years gap in under this ground only, it transformed into the diamond, that is a white diamond, that is the permanently transformed state. Here in the transformation, what Sri Aurobindo speaks of, that is a very interesting topic, that permanent mother quotes here about her own transformation. Mother quotes, "I have transformed my ill-shaped brittle clay." We know Mother is uncomparable, incredible, so beauty in all aspects. Mother are uncomparable because she is the incarnation, supramental incarnation. Still then Mother quotes and tries to explain on this transformation very interestingly. Mother quotes, "I have transformed my ill-shaped brittle clay." This clay, that is brittle and ill-shaped, not in proper shape, that has been transformed by me. I have transformed my ill-shaped brittle clay into the hardness of the statued soul. So just imagine soul, it is not at all visible, not touchable, not actually, just we see, we just imagine something is there. It can't be cut, it can't be burned, it can't be washed, it can't be thrown away. It is immortal, it is inside us, the spark of the absolute, that we have not seen it. In some description we have seen, not bigger than the thumb of a man. So this soul is transformed into the statued God. Just imagine this is transformation. Again, Sri Aurobindo quotes on Mother, "A last and mightiest transformation came on her, last and mightiest transformation, till we have known by that updated the phrase, the remark is there from us. Transformation means up to we have gone into the white diamond itself." Again, Mother quotes, "A last and mightiest transformation came on her, against Europe, the tries to put very interestingly the on transformation. Then with a magic transformation speed, that is a transformation speed means it is a great speed, it can't be imagined, it can't be of course reached, unreachable, incredible. So a transformation speed, they rushed into each other and they grew one. That is the on what Sri Aurobindo has quoted. Anyway, few lines we'll see on transformation from Sri Aurobindo's quotings, of course. Then we'll go for the mother's voice, mother's writings, mother's imagination, of course, mother's message on transformation. Sri Aurobindo quotes, it is not a hope but a certitude. That what until now what I feel, some people will be thinking, of course, people who are aware, who are in a larger consciousness, higher consciousness, who are actually aware, they are, for them things are happening, they know they are aware. But still some people will be there, they will be a first time learner from this transformation. They don't have the any in-depth idea, of course. For them, Sri Aurobindo quotes, it is not a hope but a certitude that the complete transformation of the nature will take place. Complete transformation, not towards the point of the black diamond pole or to the white diamond. After white diamond also some places will be there, some stages will be there that our science and our idea or our thought has not approached. Anyway, the Sri Aurobindo quotes, it is not a hope but a certitude that a complete transformation of the nature will take place. Again, the secret of the transformation, how, where lies the secret of transformation? We have seen that the king Midas, he got the boon, he actually got the boon, whom he will touch, it will be converted to the gold. It was done, but whatever and which one he touched, it turned into gold, his like his house, his palace, his courts, anything he touched, his bed, everything was turned to gold. Finally, he was feeling hungry when he was trying to take some food. That food was tossed by Midas and it also turned to gold. That was very tragic thing, but he will, how shall he survive? That was the major problem. Again, his darling daughter, his teeny daughter, very loving daughter, he came and actually came and tossed the father Midas, King Midas, his father, her father. And also she turned to the gold. That was the breaking point. So this Midas finally goes to the Lord who offered the boon and requests him in a light and eye full of tears, just take back my that boon, I don't want, I want simply to leave that the great, that the uncertainty is not actually applicable to us. Anyway, Mother Sri Aurobindo quotes, the secret of transformation lies in the transference of our center of living to a higher consciousness. Here we are living, our center of life, living here in the lower hemisphere in a very confined and limited atmosphere. But this center of living has to be extended, has to be, of course, lifted to a higher consciousness. And in a change of our main power of living, center of consciousness, living, and it must be elevated, it must be spinned upwards to a higher consciousness. That is the, there lies the secret of our transformation. Again, Sri Aurobindo quotes, the transformation of the body is the must be the first condition for the total transformation of the nature. The, for the entire transformation of the body, actually, the transformation of entire transformation of the nature, for the entire transformation of the nature, transformation of the body is the first condition or precondition, what is Sri Aurobindo quotes. And for the transformation of the body, some sort of work, for the proper balance of the body, some work must be there. And work done that will be in two spirit, of course, and in the for the divine, that is most essential. Again, Mother quotes, Sri Aurobindo quotes, this transformation can only be done by a force infinitely greater than your own. Nobody can transform himself by his own unaided effort. Without unaided effort, unaided effort, it can be done. With only the added effort. Added effort means not from our father, brother, sister, friends, not like this. It is from the Supreme Mother, because this is infinitely greater than man's own. So this, whatever this father, mother, they belongs to the human level and they have got their limited strength. Again, man can't be by his own effort make himself greater than man. He has got limitation with his own effort. If he is efforting hard, you without effort, if then only the best thing we can do, he can become a man, nothing more than a man. Man, then you, that aspiration finally, it is a day dream for her. Again, we are going to quote few lines from mother's quotations, of course. There is a supreme divine consciousness, mother quotes initially, very interestingly. There is a supreme divine consciousness. We want to manifest the divine consciousness in the physical life. Your mother has quoted many times, tried also that physical transformation, cellular transformation. Anyhow, she has succeeded a lot. She has displayed many things have happened to her. But in our, because she is divine incarnation, supramental incarnation, so so far we are concerned, we have to take her help, guidance. That is the most the immediate and instantaneous requirement for us. The goal is not to lose oneself in the divine consciousness. The goal is not lose oneself in the divine consciousness. That is not the word the world yogis, world methodologist they were doing. The goal is to let the divine consciousness penetrate into matter and transform it. People who are actually simply they were just neglecting life, they were turning their face and moving from the worldly atmosphere life, and they were moving towards the divine. I don't know whether how much they have succeeded, still then something is done. But the goal of this yoga is to let the divine consciousness penetrate into matter and transform it. It will penetrate into matter and transform it. That is the goal, of course, it is the goal of our yoga. Again, true spirituality transform life. Mother, beautiful course, true spirituality transform life. The life must be transformed and true spirituality transform life. Again, mother has quote, silence all outside noise, silence all outside noise, aspire for the divine's help. From the outside knowledge, try to silence it. Aspire for the divine's help. Open integrally to it when it comes, and surrender to the action, and it will be effectively bring out your transformation. This silence is required, divine help is required, integrality is required. When the force is coming, there must be surrender in action. That is why these are the requirements for us. Transformation is a change by which, mother quotes, all the elements and all the movements of the being, all the elements of the being, all the movements of the being become ready for to manifest the supramental truth. Again, mother quotes finally very beautifully. Somebody asked me, in the work of transformation, who is slowest to do his part, man or God? That beautiful question was asked. In the work of transformation, who is the slowest to do his part, either man or God, who is slowest? Mother replies, man finds the God is too slow to answer his prayers. Man finds God is too slow to answer his prayer. God finds man is too slow to receive his influence. So there is a, of course, a spectacular misunderstanding between God and man. But for the truth consciousness, all is going on as it ought to go. So everything is as usual. Those who are ready for the transformation can do it anywhere you can do it, and those who are not ready can do wherever they are. Then again, one thing you must know and never forget, in the work of the transformation, all that is true and sincere will always be kept, only what is false and insincere that will go. So for the transformation, only truth is required. And again, sincerity is the most requirement in our transformation process of transformation. Of all things, the most difficult is to bring down divine. That is the most difficult thing. Consciousness into the material world must be the endeavor to be abandoned on the account, surely not. The goal is not to lose in the divine consciousness. You belong to the stage of the spirituality that leads to reject the matter and want to escape from it. Matter is not the goal. The spirituality is to be tomorrow will take up the matter and transform it. So death transformed becomes life, that is immortality. Thank you.